Hi, I'm Richard Overdorf with Keysight Technologies. Today, we're going to review three different methods to identify pulsed or intermittent signals. I have the UXA signal analyzer, which is capable of fast sweeps, and it also has a unique LO design that gives it very good phase noise. Today, we're going to focus on the 510 megahertz of real-time bandwidth and its uncompromised dynamic range. To demonstrate this, I have a UXG signal generator that can generate signals and switch frequencies in 50 nanoseconds. It's going to generate a pulse signal environment similar to what might be seen in an EW test environment. This product, like all X-Series signal analyzers, is capable of both the traditional analog sweep and FFT stitching to move through the spectrum. Traditional analog sweeps are still used for wide frequency ranges, and FFTs are generally used for medium or smaller spans. Some of this depends on the resolution bandwidth filter and capabilities of the instrument. In general, analyzers must adhere to the following equation for sweep speeds. Looking at the diagram, you can see how the resolution bandwidth is effectively swept through the spectrum. Time is on the y-axis, and we are looking for how fast the sweep makes it through the spectrum. The black represents the signal in our environment, and if the sweep, which is in green, coincides with the signal, then it appears on the screen. Otherwise, it's missed and does not appear. In the UXA, we have fast sweep capability as a standard feature. In the analog sweep technique, we can see what the signal content is as the analyzer sweeps through the spectrum. Turning on max hold helps to understand the envelope of the spectrum. Next, let's review what the real-time mode is. In this example, the LO is fixed at a specific frequency and we digitize a large amount of spectrum. The obvious advantage is that analyzer is not missing any data in its real-time bandwidth. The UXA is capable of significantly more real-time bandwidth than is currently available in the industry at approximately 510 megahertz. Not only does this help in visualizing more spectrum, but in general, the larger the bandwidth, the smaller signal you are guaranteed to capture. In this case, it becomes apparent very quickly that we can capture all the signals virtually immediately, the most powerful way to view the intermittent signal environment. The UXA can also use a real-time dwell technique called step density to visualize the full range of the signal environment. Looking at this in the UXA, we can see signals across 1.5 gigahertz of bandwidth. It can enable us to more easily understand a wide spectrum. With this technique, we are dwelling in segments of the spectrum using the real-time DSP engine. The drawback? When the signal only occurs once or has a very low duty cycle, we still might miss them with this technique. Inside the analyzer's real-time bandwidth, we guarantee that we can detect any occurrence of a very short duration of the signal. Let's use the density display to review the spectral environment. I'm going to focus in on the chirp here. As you can see, there are multiple pulses in this frequency range. I'm going to try and trigger on one of these signals using a frequency match trigger. With the frequency match trigger, we're going to look at the signals in the shaded region. I want to see if any of these signals are of a duration longer than 10 microseconds. By using the time qualified trigger criteria, I can see that these signals are not less than 10 microseconds in duration. If I switch to greater than 10 microseconds and less than 10 milliseconds, I can see that the signals are in this range. I could use this trigger to set up a recording or further qualify the signals to ascertain the approximate duration of each pulse. Today, we have reviewed three types of analysis. First, a fast sweep technique, which is still very useful for wideband signal environments. Using new algorithms similar to those in an ELINT receiver, we are able to fairly quickly see both low and high level signals. Second is the step density. It is best at finding signals at a defined repetition rate. For example, you can find all signals that repeat over a specified interval. Finally, we looked at the wideband real-time technique. This is very good if you don't need an extremely wide bandwidth and you're capable of accurately identifying really short duration signals and also triggering on specific signals of interest. With the UXA, you have the highest performance real-time wideband analyzer on the market today. It allows you to see the real performance of your device. For more information, contact your local representative, visit the URL on the screen, or view more real-time signal analyzer videos. Thank you.